Welcome to an example of a pediatric medication calculation that will be determined using proportions. A proportion is made when we set two ratios or rates equal to each other, as we see here, where as long as the units of A and C are the same and the units of B and D are the same, then A times D must equal B times C. And these are called cross products. So if we have one unknown, we can solve for the unknown using the cross products. Here we're given a 20-pound, 6-ounce child is to receive medication ordered 20 micrograms per kilogram of body weight. How many micrograms should the child receive? To set up the proportion, we'll begin with the known rate of 20 micrograms per kilogram. So we can write this as 20 micrograms per 1 kilogram must be equal to. The second rate would deal with the given weight of the child. Since kilograms is weight, the 20 pounds, 6 ounces must go on the bottom. The numerator would be the number of micrograms, which is unknown, so we'll say x micrograms. Notice in this form we cannot cross multiply because our denominator contains different units. Here we have kilograms, and here we have both pounds and ounces. So we'll first convert these two to a common unit. We'll convert the 6 ounces to pounds, and then we'll have to convert the pounds to kilograms. So again, for the first step, we're going to convert 6 ounces to pounds, and we'll use the conversion 16 ounces equals 1 pound. So these two will give us our first ratio for the proportion. We'll have 16 ounces is to 1 pound as 6 ounces would be to an unknown number of pounds, which we'll call y pounds. Notice we do have the same units on the top and on the bottom, so we can go ahead and cross multiply and solve for y. When cross multiplying, we will leave off the units. So we'll have 16 times y equals 1 times 6. 16 times y is 16y equals 1 times 6, of course, is 6. Divide both sides by 16. So we have y equals 6 sixteenths, or 3 eighths. That simplifies. But we do want to convert this to a decimal, and then we'll round to 2 decimal places. So to convert this to a decimal, we'll divide 3 by 8. So 3 divided by 8 is 0.375. If we want to round to the hundredth, or 2 decimal places, notice how this 5 here is our decision maker. 5 or more, we round up. 4 or less, we round down. Because we have a 5 here, round up by changing this to 0.38. Which means 6 ounces is approximately 0.38 pounds. So now we can rewrite this as 20.38 pounds. But notice how we still have different units on the bottom. Here we have kilograms, and here we have pounds. So now we'll convert 20.38 pounds to kilograms using another proportion. The conversion we'll use is 2.2 pounds is approximately 1 kilogram. So this will give us our first ratio. 2.2 pounds is to 1 kilogram as 20.38 pounds is to an unknown number of kilograms. We'll call it Z kilograms. We have the same units on top and on the bottom. So we can cross multiply and solve for the unknown. So we have 2.2 times z must equal 1 times 20.38. So we have 2.2z equals 20.38. Divide both sides by 2.2. So z will be equal to this quotient here, which we'll have to round. So 20.38 divided by 2.2. is going to be approximately 9.26 if we round this to 2 decimal places. Again, here we have a 3 to the right, keeping this a 6, so 9.26. So finally, we have the proportion that we need to solve this problem. We can replace 20.38 pounds with 9.26 kilograms. So 20 micrograms is to 1 kilogram as x micrograms is to 9.26 kilograms. So because we have the same units on top and on the bottom, we can now cross multiply and solve for x. 1 times x must equal 20 times 9.26. Well, 1 times x is just x, and 20 times 9.26 will give us the number of micrograms needed for this child. micrograms. I hope you found this helpful.